Bitcoin crashed 54% from the top. Ethereum crashed 58%. And if you were on the Binance futures market, your Ethereum went down a crazy 68%. That's a lot. But that just makes me more interested in Ethereum. In this video, I'll first share what I think can happen next with Bitcoin, because Bitcoin has been leading the dump. So we need to understand that first. But then I'll go into detail in Ethereum. Elon Musk didn't shoot down Bitcoin. Tesla didn't sell. We got played, he got played. That's the game, guys. What really happened was that large sellers used that news to amplify the impact of their sell orders towards the end of their distribution, their sell-off phase. Maybe they've been even waiting for the next bad news to start dumping. It was just a lucky break for them that something that newsworthy came up. If you've seen me talk about this on Ivan's channel already, you can skip ahead 2 minutes. So the preset is that the market is manipulated. The big players loaded up early, maybe around here. Then they drove the price up with aggressive buying. Then they want to sell with as little price impact as possible, so they get as good price as possible. That means they need the buyers to wanting to buy, right? Then how do they do that in the most optimal way? How do they play the public's emotions for maximum gain? That's what this model shows. It's soon 100 years old and it still works today in 2021 because it plays on human emotion, and those aren't changing. Wyckoff was upset that the whales of his time were manipulating the public, and he wanted to educate people on what's really going on. First they drive the price up. Then they start offloading here at PSY, preliminary supply. Then drive price up again to this BC buying climax. Here everyone was euphoric. If you remember, no matter how much Bitcoin you had, you felt that you were missing the boat and you were itching to buy more. Then there is an automatic reaction down, seems normal, then up again for a secondary test. Then the first surprise hits. SOW, sign of weakness. Here we were supposed to be euphoric. Then there is suddenly a weakness in the chart. We hit below previous support. Many people will panic, it's over, people will flip short. Then they run the price up again, up thrust, tricking everyone, beyond the previous high, liquidating those that shorted. Down a little, people are buying the bags of the whales like crazy here, and up thrust after distribution. Laser eyes are glowing, max euphoria, the whales are unloading their bags easily. Then the dip again, and now begins the last part of the game. Last point of supply. Bags are beginning to empty and the whales have one big shot left. Here they load up their shorts and then stop caring about whether they move the price and just begin offloading supply. That's where some negative news like the Elon environmental concern can really amplify the crash. One final trick. Show a sign of weakness here. Everyone shorts, then drive it up again to liquidate those, a short squeeze. Then hard down, that's what we got this Wednesday. Now before everyone jumps in here and says that they heard about Wyckoff a long time ago on this or that channel with, I think, Uncomplication doing its best. After I had realized this, I decided to check with this guy, who is the owner Wyckoff Stock Market Institute, founded by Richard D. Wyckoff in 1931. And this was before the Wednesday dump on 19th. This was on the 18th, and he said this was not textbook Wyckoff. The buying climax haven't increased volume. This dude probably knows Wyckoff better than your average YouTuber, but maybe he was wrong, because it did dump the day after, consistent with the last leg of Wyckoff distribution. This just shows that in reality you need multiple indicators working together to make sense of the world. That's at least my conclusion. No one knows everything. My Lars Online indicator has really been life-changing for me. But even with that, you're stronger the more you know. So who was it if it wasn't Elon Musk? If you press the like button now, the answer will reveal. Thank you. For sure, large Chinese holders have for quite a while known that things are tightening over there. So for sure, there are large players there that must sell. And then maybe buy back later in another capacity, organized under a different jurisdiction maybe. If that theory is correct, that doesn't mean that it's someone that no longer believes in Bitcoin that sold. That's good in that case. Anyway, it doesn't matter who. Institutions. Let's go back to the price action. What about now? Are they done? Was $30,000 here the final flush out where they sold their last BTC, closed their shorts and walked away richer than ever, waiting to reload at the next accumulation and do it all over again? Or do they have more ammunition left for this dump? There is no way to know for sure. It is common for the price to reach into the area marked as support here after the distribution is done. But then that support turns into resistance and price heads down again. It is important to understand this before we go into Ethereum, because if this dumps, Ethereum will dump more. And if Bitcoin recovers, Ethereum will surely go up too in the short term. The risk is definitely significantly higher now than it was in the middle of the solid uptrend we've had for almost a year. So what I will say next is not financial advice for you. I'm just sharing what I am doing. This might not apply to you at all in your situation. For me, this casino money could disappear tomorrow and I'll still be fine. I'll still have money to trade with next week. Don't gamble away all your money on one bad trade, guys. At the euphoria phase, laser eyes to 100k, everyone was wrong. Now we are at max fear. Everyone is scared. Will everyone be right this time? I doubt it. I think we will still see higher prices later. Maybe we get another dip to the 30k to 35k range. Maybe we get one more dip into 25k. If that happens, that would present buying opportunities in Ethereum, because I do see the possibility of significantly higher valuations in the future. But as I explained, another Bitcoin dump might not happen if they are already out of ammo. And then Bitcoin may slowly grind up from here. And then I think Ethereum will too. Let's look at Ethereum in relation to Bitcoin. The ETH-BTC chart painted this inverse head and shoulders from 2018 until 2021. Now that target has almost been met, so that worked out great. But that the target has been met doesn't mean that the chart automatically flips bearish. This line here is where Ethereum would flip Bitcoin as the number one crypto by market cap based on today's circulating supply. That doesn't look so far away, does it? Then let's look at this on the Ethereum.org homepage. The merge. Eventually, the current Ethereum mainnet will be merged with the Beacon Chain proof of stake system. Then there's a notification here. Latest. ETH2 researchers are working on ways to accelerate its merge. It will probably happen earlier than expected. Ethereum will be completing the transition to proof of stake in the upcoming months. That would then reduce energy by more than 99.95%, which would then address Elon Musk's concern. Could that change the narrative? Guys, I know that the energy concerns are overblown. Bitcoin and Ethereum proof of work is far more energy efficient than, for example, gold mining or the old monetary system with millions of bank offices with air conditioning and people driving to work. But who cares? Gold and fiat were yesterday's competition to Bitcoin. Tomorrow's competition will be other cryptocurrencies. And from that vantage point, Ethereum is well positioned to really challenge Bitcoin here. A lot of people will now jump into the comments and write impossible. Go ahead. Just be aware that change like this always feels utterly impossible until it happens, and then it seems obvious. What are your thoughts? I'm going to keep an open mind. I trade possibilities, not predictions, not probabilities. Just, is it a possibility or not? And is it possible for Ethereum to overtake Bitcoin as the number one cryptocurrency? Yes, I think it is possible. We have a long, fine tradition in crypto. If Bitcoin pumps, alts dump. If Bitcoin dumps, alts dump more. That's where we are now. But then if Bitcoin consolidates, alts often pump. So if Bitcoin starts to consolidate here after these massive moves, that could mean more fuel to ETH-BTC. And we know that Uniswap is going to add Ethereum Layer 2 functionality with Optimism later in the summer, which could give the Ethereum ecosystem a rematch opportunity against BSC, etc. All in all, I think Ethereum is interesting here. Now this is important. YouTube has stopped showing my videos to people not already subscribed. You're going to need to subscribe and bell, and I ask you to humbly please share this video if you found it useful. I'm not advising you to do anything. Thank you, tack. CTO Larsson out. Hej då!